So we've covered how to use the limiters. We've covered how to use phrase searching, and right now we have three phrases included in our search. We've also talked about each of the Boolean operators. The next thing that I want to talk to you about is called truncation. Truncation lets you search for a word that could have multiple endings. A truncated word search will return a larger set of search results than a regular keyword search. I'm just going to type this in this third search box, but this is not going to be added to our search. I just want to give you a visual demonstration about what a truncated word would look like. And this is also included in your outline. If we were to search for the word music with the asterisk following wherever that word could possibly change, then we will bring back any variations of this. So this search would look for music, musical, musicality, musician, musicians, musicals. Okay? So again, obviously this does not apply to our search, but I just wanted to show you that on screen. So one way we could truncate our search is if we were to look for engage with the asterisk. This search would return engage, engages, engaged, engagement, engagements. Okay, so this would return a broader set than we're looking at now, I imagine, quite significantly, since we're looking for any variation of engage anywhere in the article. So you don't always necessarily need to broaden your search, but think about the words that you're using in your searches and look to see if they could possibly be truncated, because this is much easier than trying all the different variations in separate searches. Now, there is also a way to search for variations of a word that aren't on the end, and these are called wildcards. So I'm just going to return to the research process to quickly show you an example of a wildcard symbol. Okay, so the examples used here are applied to databases such as EBSCOhost and ProQuest. Basically, a wildcard is used to replace an unknown character. So an example here would be the word woman or women. Because the spelling is different, we wouldn't want to put the asterisk there because we wouldn't want to find any words that start with W-O-M that aren't related to women or a woman. So we would replace where the E or the A would go with the question mark. Now, you can always consult each individual database to see if they offer the wildcard option. We do have links for EBSCOhost, Scale, and ProQuest wildcards and truncation symbols down here at the bottom.